Hello, humans. Welcome back to Dr. Rose Helps You Here. I'm Stephanie Rose, and today we're going to be talking about, is it okay to wear someone else's hearing aids? I see this question a lot on social media, and there are certain situations where it might be okay, but there are enough reasons why it's probably not okay. Hearing loss is like a fingerprint. Everybody's is different. So the reason why we go to see a specialist is to get the appropriate recommendation for the type of equipment and sound that you need to help your hearing loss. So when it comes to wearing someone else's, basically it's going to be, is it programmed for you and does it fit you well? So the sound is what it comes down to. The other major factor we have to consider is hygiene. When you borrow someone else's hearing aid, it's been sitting in a warm, moist ear canal of some other human. And studies have shown that we can harbor viruses, bacteria, and fungus in the ear canal, and this can easily transfer to the tiny nooks and crannies that are in hearing aids. We'll get into the visuals of that in just a moment. So backtracking to the fit. There are basically two types of hearing aids that you can get. You can have a behind-the-ear style, or you can have an in-the-ear style. For the in-the-ear style, these are actually custom fit, so they are only made for the person that the impression was taken for in the ear. And this one actually is not made for my ear, and you can see that it's kind of protruding a little bit. It's uncomfortable to wear. And something that's uncomfortable and protruding or not fitting your ear canal properly is going to give you feedback, so lots of squealing. And yes, there are ways in the software that we can kind of help this a little bit, but what that sacrifices is your sound prescription. So again, it comes down to the fidelity or the sound of the hearing aid. So that's not going to be a very good option to wear someone else's custom in-the-ear hearing aid. For the behind-the-ear hearing aids, we actually have two different types, and this is just a dummy hearing aid of a receiver in canal. And this would be my choice if I had to fit someone with someone else's hearing aid due to financial or economic issues. This would be my style of choice. Why? Because we can remove the ear wire that was in the ear and put a new wire on, and then hopefully tailor that speaker to the amount of power that they need for their hearing loss, and then also the tip to change the acoustics so that it's optimal for the shape. So basically just making the sound appropriate for the person's hearing loss. The type that has the tubing that comes down that has a custom fit ear mold, and then a bigger behind the ear type hearing aid that sends the sound down the tube and into the ear. This is not as ideal in that it doesn't fit a variety of hearing losses and it occludes the ear a lot. You could make an ear mold that has some good venting in it, but they're just a little less versatile, I'll say. And you certainly wouldn't want to use someone else's ear mold in your ear because, again, you're having that fit and feedback issue. So if I had to pick a hearing aid to fit to someone else, it would be this receiver in canal style. Okay, this is the newest one by Widex, and it's called the Moment. But with that aside, you also wanna be careful where you're finding these hearing aids. If someone gifts it to you, you definitely wanna get a professional's opinion, have your hearing tested, and see if this is actually a good hearing aid that could be used for you. There's nothing wrong with doing that as long as we can get all the components nice and clean and replace anything that would actually be in your ear. But let's say that you just wanted to hear what someone else hears through their hearing aid. There's a couple of problems with this. Number one, of course, fit. We've already talked about that. Their ear is not going to be the same as your ear. But also, there's actually a dangerous component to this where you could actually give yourself noise-induced hearing loss by listening to someone else's hearing aid. Hearing aids can be incredibly loud. In fact, they can put out sound pressure levels that can cause instant damage to a normal hearing ear or even someone with just a little bit of hearing loss. So you never, ever, ever want to put someone else's hearing aid on for the purposes of protecting your own ear and hearing health. Okay, humans, for those of you who are squeamish, you might want to stop the video at this point. But now I'm going to talk about otitis externa. So What happens when our outer ears get infected? Well, the infection can carry from the eardrum all the way to the outside of the ear and can encompass the outer ear as well. So otitis, meaning inflamed ear, and then externa, meaning the external ear. Otitis externa can be caused from having too moist of an ear canal, and sometimes it's referred to as swimmer's ear. But we see this a lot with hearing aid patients who need a good seal, a lot of sound, and have a lot of perspiration in the ear, and maybe can't have too big of a vent or a tunnel running through the hearing aid to the inner part of the canal because of sound loss and feedback issues. Okay, so this first case of otitis externa comes to you from Wikipedia, but this is actually a moderate case of otitis externa. You can see that there are some crusting happening and oozing happening at the ear canal entrance, and a lot of times we see that it becomes really narrow at the ear channel, so you can't even get a hearing aid in here at that point, and you should definitely discontinue use of your hearing aids if you start to have any itching, pain, swelling, or drainage in your ears. Here's a more mild case of otitis externa. When I see this, it just kind of looks like a dry outer ear, but you can see that there's a lot of dermatitis, but then if you look at that entrance, it looks a little more narrow than normal. So that's definitely some inflammation happening and probably more like the beginning stages of a otitis externa infection happening. Here's a more severe case of otitis externa. You can definitely see there's a lot of infection happening and coming out of the ear here. This is something that would be extremely painful and very sensitive to the touch. And you know, if someone had a hearing aid in their ear at the beginning of stages of this, you could actually transfer the infection to another ear canal. So again, very important to keep your hands clean, keep your hearing aids clean, and don't stick your fingers in your ears so that this doesn't happen. According to the Mayo Clinic, the otitis externa is actually very common, more than 200,000 US cases per year. It's treated by a medical professional, usually self-diagnosable, and it's short-term, so it resolves within days to weeks when you have medical intervention. You can see in this picture here that there's inflammation in the ear canal, and it shows a picture of this lady who's in a lot of pain. If you do a Google image search for otitis externa, there's some really great little differentiators up here that you can click on to see exactly what different types look like. So let's try the fungal one because that's always fun. So these are fungal infections in the ear. Sometimes when you look inside there, it looks like almost like a Q-tip, like cotton fuzz. So usually it's like a white fuzzy material that you'll see mixed in with some ooze. And then when it gets dark like this one, that's actually not a good sign. These can be more advanced fungal infections when they're dark like this in color. Definitely very hard to get rid of. And those little micro spores can get into the nooks and crannies of a hearing aid. And even if you wipe it down, sometimes that fungal infection can return because little tiny spores live in the nooks and crannies. You think that your infection's gone, you've gone through treatment, you wear your hearing aid again, and suddenly you're right back to symptoms. So in the cases of fungal infections, a lot of times I'll send the hearing aid out to the manufacturer to have them completely overhaul, take apart the whole unit, add a new shell in there. If it's a receiver and canal, then I will replace the whole entire receiver wire and wipe down the shell on the outer part too with some cavicide so that it can kill whatever's on there. The hearing aid spray by Otologist Choice, I believe, is antimicrobial and can help with things like fungus on ear molds and hearing aids. Here's another one. So basically this is a fungal otitis externa. And when it's like this, sometimes it's hard to know if there's fungus in here because it's really wet and almost looks like wax and epithelial tissue that's really just moist. So sometimes you won't know that it's a fungus until you actually have the otologist or ENT look at it under a microscope. With our little, you know, 10-fold otoscopes, sometimes you can't really see the tiny spores that are happening in there. But basically, from what I understand, the doctor will just remove all of this debris and treat the canal with a medication. And then sometimes you'll go home with some ear drops to continue to clear that infection. Are you guys getting hungry yet? Here comes some more. So this one's really interesting. It's got some of the what looks like sand sometimes in the ear canal, and it's got that darker kind of fungus, and then we have these like white hairs that come out, and sometimes it's hard to tell, is that the ear hair or is it fungus? So anytime I see anything that looks like this, it's an immediate referral to the ear physician to get that taken care of because they are so hard to treat. I have to confess, I'm such a hearing nerd. I could sit here and look at these pictures all day long. I'm sorry for any of you who are squeamish out there, really regretting watching this video, but I'll do one more and this is gonna be the best one. Here it comes. Okay, so here's the grand finale. We've got a bunch of wax and fungal infection towards the center here. And then at the top, you can see that it's noted as a draining infection. So this is something, whenever we have drainage coming out of the ear, we call it otorrhea. So otorrhea mixed in with wax and fungus, and who knows, there are probably some bacteria in there as well. I mean, that's just like a whole petri dish of outer ear infection or otitis externa. Anytime you go to do otoscopy or look into someone's ear, I try to do a quick glance just at the very outer edge of the canal. So what can I see right here? If I see a bunch of junk in there, I don't just go ahead and stick it all the way in because you could be shoving that infection further back. So you can kind of sometimes see this, you know, approaching the very outer portion of the ear when you're going to look in. So you just wanna be really careful, inspect the whole outer ear first before you actually stick in your scope for your audiologists out there who are learning, audiology students out there learning. And when you see something like this for the first time, you have to almost excuse yourself and have like an out-of-body experience because the last thing you want to do is scare the patient. So you just have to kind of formulate what you would say if you find this and kind of rehearse it, say it to yourself a few times, while you're practicing for clinic. So, oh, it appears that you have some debris in your ear. It could be an infection, so we need to get you over to the ear doctor right away. And then just, you know, end with a smile, very calm. Don't show them, you know, your scared face because it's scary. It's scary to see things like this in the ear. Same thing if you were to find like a bug or some other foreign object that looked a little scary. And we do find bugs, and I'll do a whole other video on that for you guys sometime.
Also, just a quick reminder, if you do find any evidence of potential infection in outer ears of your patients, you want to definitely tell them to discontinue use of the hearing aids, clean them up as much as you can, and if you suspect fungus, probably want to process a repair and have the maker totally clean it out. So that is basically the outcome of what you do when you find someone with this condition. And again, you know, tying this all back to the purpose of this video, we don't want to share hearing aids. Don't put someone else's hearing aid in your ear. Even if you wipe it down, you don't know what could be hiding in those nooks and crannies. It's not made for your hearing loss. It's not made for your ear canal. So it's not like putting on someone else's cheater eyeglasses. And even with our eyes, like I have an asymmetry. One of my eyes is weaker, so I can't just put on someone else's eyeglasses that have, you know, a same detriment because I have different detriments in my eyes. And same thing can happen with the ears. Someone can have a weak speaker on one side and an ultra power on the other, and you put that hearing aid in your ear and boom, you have tinnitus for 4 days and maybe a significant change in your hearing. So definitely protect your hearing, protect your ear health, and don't wear other people's hearing aids. All right, humans, that's the rest of today's video. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you weren't too squeamish. And I will try to bring you a nice light video next week. I hope you all stay well out there. I'm in California right now, so I just want to say I hope everyone's staying safe from all the wildfires. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you next time.